G'day beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be looking at a build for Bellica, which is awesomely named Bellica. It should be Lieutenant Smelly Fart, but we'll fix that in a minute. Bellica is one of my favorite heroes. When she first came out, I played her a ton. She's gone through a bunch of changes, fallen off, come back a little bit, and she's in a pretty decent spot right now. With the emphasis on having some burst casters on your team, on enemy teams these days, she can be a very, very good shout, but you need to realize that you're actually missing out on a burst caster having her on your team, but she can be played as support anyway. So let's take a look at this. Just as we get into it, I'm gonna start doing hero guides again soon, probably in the next 2 days. I might do, if the patch notes pop out tomorrow, I'll probably do a patch notes video and then do a hero guide the next day. It's probably going to be on Murdoch. I'm going to work my ass off on that tomorrow. I should have all day to actually get that done. They do take a bit of effort, so keep your eyes out for that. I'm very excited to start doing them again. So the build. Alright, so we have Rejuvenator. It's a consumable potion that gives you health regen and mana regen for 10 seconds. It's a pretty good card. Don't grab it too often, but it's nice to have it there. Advanced Evolution. Restore max health and max mana per second for 3 seconds after leveling up. Font of Experience, obviously our starting card because you want to get those abilities as soon as you can. Mana Flow Acolyte to increase max mana and power by 0.5% when purchasing Intellect. Considering that it costs 3 to get into it, I don't think it works retroactively, so I don't think you get the 0.5% for the 3 you've already spent. So that leaves 22 points left into intellect, so that's 11%. And this works very well with Thaumaturge when you have Deadly Mana on as one of your gems. We have Astral Leap, just because she doesn't have any getaways, she only has a knockup to rely on, so having this is quite nice, but you can't use it when you've been hit by damage, so you need to get out of there early. So we have Power Tap. Just this goes on all my caster builds. Don't always use it. There's been a few occasions where I've used it on Gideon when I've got to max intellect, and it's really nice. Glycerin Dawn, Lotra Fireball, dealing 150 damage plus 15 per hero level ability damage, and Burn for 200 ability damage over 4 seconds. This can really hurt quite a lot, and it's going to give you some power. Then we have Riot Sapper. It's the main part of the build. Remove 40% current mana from nearby enemy heroes, dealing ability damage equal to mana removed. What I tend to do is, once I pop my drone down, I instantly hit them with this. So I'll go in on them, I'll pop my drone down, I will pop this, try to knock them up and hit them with a void bomb. By this time, they've been sacked of a bit of their mana. You know, they've taken damage from your knockup and your bomb, and you've removed 40% of their current mana, and there's a good chance that you may get a kill off your ultimate from that point. Then we have Static Trap, which is in here just in case you want to run it to be a smart ass and knock people up, put a Static Trap underneath them. It can be quite dirty. And if you have your Void Drone out, sapping their mana, having them stunned for an extra 1.8 seconds is quite handy, getting that extra mana off. Thaumaturge, gain power equal to 1% mana. As we said before, it's going to work well with Mana Flow Acolyte. Then we have Atomic Soldier, everybody knows this card, and Corrosive Walker, which is very, very good because it reduces enemy ability armor by 30 for 6 seconds, but it also gives you 25 power and 385 max health when compared to Atomic Soldier, which is 4 attribute points cheaper, 15 power. So this is pretty much 50% more expensive than Atomic Soldier. And it gives you pretty good boost in stats for that 50% increase in cost. We take Healing Towers because I do generally run her as a mid laner, but if you're going to run support, maybe you might want to go for something different. I run Onslaught, reduce cooldowns by 0.2 when you land a basic attack. Deadly Mana, which works very well with Thaumaturge. Mana Fountain, Spell Shield, and overpowered spells, just to make sure that ultimate does as much as possible and my void bomb does as much as possible. It's very, very nice. So generally what my end game build looks like is Atomic Soldier, Riot Sapper, and Glycerin Dawn. So as I said, with Riot Sapper, what I tend to do is put my drone down, use Riot Sapper, knock them up, use my Void Bomb, and then once I've got my Void Bomb down, just hit them with a Glycerin Dawn. Not many heroes are going to survive all that, or they're at least going to be that close to death that it's not going to matter how high their mana pool is, you're going to kill them. If you don't want to go for that, a lot of people don't do this, but I would recommend actually go for Mana Flow Acolyte, Thaumaturge, and Atomic Soldier. People don't tend to run Thaumaturge and Mana Flow Acolyte, but the two of them actually work really well together, especially when you have deadly mana. The more mana you have, the better, and considering that Bellica's Void Bomb gives us some mana back, it's quite easy to actually stay up on mana, provided you're hitting a lot of minions with that Void Bomb. That's the build, guys. Also should say, if you want to get rid of Atomic Soldier for Corrosive Walker, that is a good shout. And probably a different way to run the build would actually be to go for Riot Sapper, Atomic Soldier, and Corrosive Walker. That would be dirty. I hope you enjoyed the videos, guys. If you did, smash the like button, leave me a comment, let me know what you think. Subscribe for more Paragon content. With that said, thank you so much for watching. Love your face. Catch you in the next one. Peace.